This is a deeply inherent property to any intervention that we perform to suppress any undesired complex additive system. I mentioned this backfiring of the war on terrorism and in coup d'etat, sanctions and so on. If we are not completely successful, and we rarely are, then the system that we try to suppress will respond in a way that our actions look like they backfire. And this phenomenon can be described in crisp mathematical terms, which we don't want to do here, but it has to do with non-linear dynamics of complex systems. Now, this mindset that you can just go and kill is still prevalent in cancer research. It is essentially a mindset that is based on a linear thinking of the tumor and of therapy being a zero-sum game, so that you go and you kill, and then if you kill only 80% of the cells, then you can come back later and use a more potent drug to kill off the remaining 20%. That's not how it works. Once you've killed 80% of the cancer cells, the entire tissue changes, the 20% or 10% or even 1% of tumor cells that survive will be different, because they also have seen the drug. They have undergone a near-death stress situation. If somebody undergoes a near-death stress situation, it changes one's life. And so are these cancer cells. They're completely different after therapy, even without mutations. So typically, this cell stress would push cells into a repair mode, and that is also called stem cells. The cells can divide because they think there's something going on and they want to repair. But this is a cancer cell, so it's an abnormal stem cell, an abnormal repair response, and we know these cells now as so-called cancer stem cells. So we create these cancer stem cells with therapy. They just stay there. We have shrunken the tumor, which is good, what you see in the CAT scan. But there's a little bit of tumor left, and that can be a danger.